How are my fellow squares doing tonight? How's your weekend?
My weekend is going great. You know, I drove to Mexico, waited at the border for 8 hours, and we're here now.
Oh my goodness.
I'll tell you, Miz, even though summer's winding down, I've decided this is fall.
Oh, hell yes. Yes.
I'm so excited, ooh, and I just can't hide it.
Yes.
Same.
Bobby K, it looks like there's somebody in the audience named Jonathan who might be giving your beard a run for its money.
And he lives in the same town as you, Bobby K. This is serious competition.
Ooh.
Beard off, beard off.
Which
beard
one?
Off, beard off.
Which one has the best beard?
I have no idea.
Because honestly, y'all could catfish for each other. If this was Tinder, this would be so close.
Mm. Oh my god!
I'm getting double vision.
Don't make me choose between these beards.
I had to trim mine up because I just kept getting it caught in zippers and sliding doors. But this is a safe length that I have it at right now.
Are those zippers from jeans?
Oh,
jeans, sweaters, the whole shebang.
It's just, oh, okay.
So ready.
I'm excited.
Let's
go. I'm ready.
Oh my god.
Live on the most popular app in the world, it's time for Clubhouse Squares, where 9 Clubhouse celebrities from around the world will help 2 contestants win the ultimate prize. That's right, it's Clubhouse Squares! And here's your host, Bobby K!
Thank you, and welcome to Clubhouse Squares, where the object of the game is to simply win tic-tac-toe 3 squares across, down, or diagonally, or acquire as many squares as you can. And it's up to each contestant to figure out if a square is indeed giving the correct answer or is just making one up. And of course, there is today's secret square. Who will find it? What will happen? Only one way to find out. It's time to play Clubhouse Square. We have 2 contestants, but before we meet them, let's meet our squares.
Oh, Bobby, thank you so much for having me tonight. Well, if I had to pick an autobiography, one, it would be at a top shop. But anyway, you know, because I'm a rich girl.
Yes.
You It would be Naomi the Ratchet, The Life of a Tight Anus.
I'm buying that book.
That's me. Yeah, I mean, obviously there's going to be a book about my life because it's so fascinating. And as a proud girl of mixed heritage, my title will be Half Becky and 100% That Bitch.
Outstanding.
Hello, hello. If I had to title my book, it would be a little long, but all these words are necessary. It would be Came Out the Womb Twirling on the Haters. Who needs a degree when you're schooled in life like me?
Nice.
I heard you did.
Hey, but you can't forget about
Wow.
Hello. Always a pleasure to be here. So if I were to title my autobiography, my life, as some of you may know, it's kind of all over the place. So my title would be Trust Me, ... It gets better. ... Maybe.
Sold. I'm buying it.
So.
Hello, 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 everyone. I'm so excited to be here. Once again, it is another lovely week for us to have a little Clubhouse Squares. And if I were to have an autobiography, I don't think it would have an actual title as so much just be like a, eh? And so you'd have an interrobang as the title. So just be like, are you reading? Yeah, I'm reading right now.
Thank you. Thank you for that introduction. And title of my autobiography would have to be, Please Don't Tell My Parents I Wrote This.
Guys, so I am so excited. So the title of my book would be Now Watch Me Whip, because I'm totally gonna whip it in life, Indiana Jones style.
Hey, 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 everybody. How's the room tonight? I feel like it's gonna be extra hot. No, actually, the name of my autobiography is going to be Papa Do Preach, You're in Trouble Now.
Ooh.
I'm good. Thank you for having me. I'm actually writing my autobiography right now, so this is perfect.
Hello. My autobiography would probably have to be titled You Can't Hurt Steel, Baby, because I just think I'm a badass, I guess. Self-proclaimed. Let's go, baby.
Hello, my autobiography's name is I Made All the Mistakes So You Don't Have To.
Ooh, that's good.
X. X.
Well, X marks the spot, so I'm going with Miz, obviously.
What a great choice you've just made.
Miz, your body is a wonderland.
Oh, you know it. Oh, my. Wait, what's the lyric? My tongue tastes like bubblegum. Is that, am I getting that lyric correct? Oh, no. We're going to do this now.
Sounds good to me.
I'm playing.
Oh my goodness, Bobby K. So I am a big Sia stan. I love the song Chandelier specifically, but even more so when it's covered by Toad from Mario. If you haven't heard that yet, it is worth a listen. And so as a decent Sia stan, I'm going to have to say it was B. 11 minutes.
Well, you know, knowing how talented that they are, I would have to think about agreeing, but my first instinct was 36 hours, so, but I think that Miz probably knows a lot more than I do, so I'm going to go with 11 minutes. I agree.
Ooh, they say it ain't easy being green, but that was all too easy, Jessica.
Thank you.
From the chandelier.
That was very aggressive, but you know what? I'm looking at beautiful Naomi, and I know Naomi has the correct answer for me.
Hey!
Well, Bobby K, when the secret square is found, somebody from the audience is going to be brought up on stage to assist Naomi the Ratchet in answering tonight's question for her.
Ooh. I hope they're verse. Hey, girl.
Oh, I'm so happy. Not expecting that at all. Woo!
I know that the other two are, so Queen Anne's Lace is not the name of a flower.
I'm gonna go with that. That sounds like a bootleg wig brand.
Listen, I really, really want to agree with you, but I'm gonna disagree.
God damn it.
Oh, technicalities, come on.
Thank you so much, and thank you.
That is some good hair.
Well, I'll go ahead and go with Jack, if that's okay.
It may not be right, but it is okay.
That is more than okay, because I just finished my autobiography. It's called Jack Lamont, A Statement Piece of Shit.
Ooh. Written in 11 minutes.
Me up.
You can find it on Christian Mingle.
That's a Christian I'd like to mingle with.
Ooh, yeah.
Well, I wish I knew what Kama Sutra was, but I can't read, so don't buy my book. But I do know what kiwi is. Didn't know it was an animal, but I know that's lime green, so maybe it'll turn neon under a light. I'm going to go with kiwi.
I'm going to go ahead and disagree.
Yeah.
Yes.
Welcome.
Holy cow. Yeah, I've been looking for love in all the wrong places. No fine girls, just ugly faces. But I really do think I can find, I think I can find the one here. As a perpetually single person, that means I am hard and jaded, but I am ready for any questions that I need to ask. I know what I need. I know what I need
check
at this point.
Check their FICO score.
I was going to check. I need, what's the credit score? What is it? Okay, so from the audience tonight, I think I'm going to bring up, we have two suitors. I'm going to bring on a date with me, Adam and Craig. I've invited them up.
Lucky boys.
Ooh,
okay, Craig, hello, Craig. Welcome, welcome.
Hello.
Accept the date invitation. That's fair. As the human equivalent of an eclipse, I do scare many a suitor away. You know, Craig, are you feeling ready to be grilled tonight?
I'm so ready.
Okay, well, welcome to A Date with Diagnosis, where it is, at just as the title says, we're going to go on a little date. And so, Craig, I have two questions for you. And if you want to answer them, good. If you don't, you're still going to hopefully answer them. So are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Okay, Craig. The first question that I have for you tonight is, so we are currently on a date, but I do know it's virtual. Because of our virtual date, what are our Zoom backgrounds going to look like?
That's a great question. Well, I want to move ahead to our honeymoon, so I think it would be like a holiday destination.
Ooh, what kind of holiday are we talking about? Are we doing beach, the mountains, the dessert?
The mountains, yeah. You know, maybe a circuit party. You know, just a great place to network and meet people.
Oh, such good networking. I've met a few of my clients there. Very professional.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're doing...
All the business you
can do. Oh, all the business. All the business. And I'm ready for some business. Okay, so we're at a circuit party. But my second and final question for you is... Yes. So I'm going to backtrack a little bit from our honeymoon. We're going to be going on our wedding night. Ooh. What kind of cake are we having on our wedding night?
That is a very good question. Well, Miz, I think it's probably going to be a space cake because you are going to take me to the moon and back with your love.
Oh,
my God! Love.
Oh, that's a great answer.
Dunning, we are floating. We are levitating. I'll be your sugar boo any day of the week, Craig.
Maybe.
Bobby K, you just have to go to the dark side of space. Yeah.
Craig, I totally checked out your ass when you came in the room. Guilty. Sorry.
It's very nice.
It's so out and show. I'm so sorry.
Thank you, Craig.
Well, I hate to be that girl, but I'm going to go with Miz again.
Yes. I have no gag reflex anymore. It really can be just, yeah, kind of whatever at this point.
How many inches is always my first question?
I mean, Mama, I'm talking in meters now. We are speaking only in meters.
I should have been chosen for the question.
I'd settle with 8.5.
Oh, sets and we know. But so, you know, I am a big fan of measuring measurements. I am a seamstress and a designer, so I do make everything that I wear. But, you know, we always are asking the big questions. How many inches are in a mile? What it takes to make you smile? You know, tell me something I don't know. So I think I'm going to go with A.
May I ask you to repeat the question? Is that terrible of me? Because to the other response.
That's a lot of inches.
The more, the merrier.
Truly.
I think I'm going to agree with Miz.
Okay. Let's see. I do something a little different this time. Megan, help me out here.
Hey, let's get. Wow, this is so tough because I'm used to a release after I hear the words come on all the time. I can't even hear with it. Oh my gosh. Okay, one more time. The years were 1983. Mm-hmm. All right, here we go. No clue on this one, Leslie. But I'm going to just take a leap of faith and say 1983.
And can we please get a towel for Eileen?
Yes, please get a towel for her.
Oh my goodness, what's happening to me here? Can I phone a friend? Let's see. Okay, let me try Becky again. Becky, help me out because I messed up last time.
The all-knowing Becky Motorlock.
And let me just say, her mind is just as sexy as her beauty.
True that.
Is she still here?
Becky. If Becky doesn't make it, I do have a hot boyfriend in the audience. Or Tom.
Oh. Yes. I'm gonna, Jessica's my friend, but I'm gonna tell you I know the answer. It's 1982.
Tom loves the song.
Come on, Eileen.
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Okay. I'm going to go with 1982. I agree. Don't do it to me. Please don't do it to me. Oh, please, come on.
Enough to get space. Enough to, well,
luckily, enough to get space, some space infinite, milk. So you better space milk that, Bobby K.
Yes. That's Tom's song right there. That's Tom's song right there.
Damn. Oddly enough, 1982 is also my body count.
Ah! Oh, hey, ain't no shame in that game.
I hope to be 1983, Miz.
Lots of lots of releases.
Show me your ways, Miz.
I am going to go with Miss Naomi Ratchet, please.
Oh, hello. Hello. I'm well douched. I'm good.
Prepared, Your Honor.
Yes, sir. LeBron James. Shit, that's difficult. You said like taurine hairspray? I think that the most theatrical bit, that's hard. They're both theatrical. All of them are theatrical, but I would say the most ideal would be Nina West.
I will wholeheartedly agree with Naomi's answer. I agree.
Hey!
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome, baby. You're a top again.
Yay.
Do, 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 do.
No, 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 no. I'm going with Jack.
I've been such an important square today. Wow. Oh, wow. Okay. You know, I really love popcorn and country music, so I think it's Orville Peck. I'm gonna say that.
I don't know who Orville Peck is.
Yeah, I love popcorn and, you know, the cuckoo bird, it pecks things. So it's perfect.
Okay, I agree with you then. Thank you, Jack.
I got you. I got you.
Sure, absolutely. Okay. I'm going to go with Jim. Jim for the block.
All right.
Let's
live life in the fast lane, Jessica.
Jim, I told
right lane with Jessica lane. Sorry, Chris.
I was just gonna say, Jim, I totally want to cut off your skin and wear it to my birthday.
That terrifies me.
Oh.
In a good way.
I love this question. I love this movie. I am a screamer, meaning I'm a fan of
screamers. And a moaner.
Yeah, just in case you're wondering. That was my alternate title for my autobiography. But no. This is the 25th anniversary of the film. So, yeah. Drew Barrymore. She was on the poster, and everybody was shocked that she got killed off first. So I'm going with Drew.
Well, you won't be shocked to hear that I agree.
Okay. We are going to go with Trenton.
All right, I promise not to fail you. Let's do this. You know, I'm on a lot of people's Schindler's lists these days. You know, I'm just trying to make a buck, you know, trying to be on the positive times. I am stuck between E.T. and Schindler's List. I'll go with my gut and I'll say Schindler's List.
Oh, goodness. Let's see. Trenton, you going with your gut, Trenton?
Yes, usually it ends up going well for me. But there is that 0.5% that it doesn't. So I'm feeling confident today, though. I'm feeling lucky, like Google says. I never click the button, but, you know, we're still here.
Okay, well, I like your gut. So let's go with your gut. I'm going to say yes.
I told you I wouldn't fail you. My list.
Hey, Bobby, I can do a really good ET. Fart ho. Thank you.
Uncanny.
Brilliant. That's nasty.
Took me 2 hours.
To get that head cold?
Yes.
I'm going to go with Ashley Michelle Fowler, please.
I mean, when it comes to the big screen, Bobby, the only thing I care about is getting on it. So I don't really track the awards that closely. But I feel like All Quiet on the Western Front came out in 76. So I would be shocked if that's the first Best Picture. And then there's Wings and Metropolis, which sound like fake films or pornos. I don't know. I'm feeling Metropolis, Bobby. I'm going to go with Metropolis.
Oh, I have no idea. Can I use my phone a friend?
Hello from the other side.
Thank God it's not Jessica's. Jessica, you're not phoning home with E.T. Or as I like to say, this is Hollywood Boulevard E.T. Christina.
Phone home. I had to do it again. I worked so hard on it.
Oh, wow.
So proud of you. So proud of you.
Wings.
Yeah, very confident.
Since Eden sounded so confident, I'm going to agree with Eden and go with Wings as well.
I mean, I'm going to, yeah, go with the majority and say Wings as well. I agree with Eden and Tommy. Thank you.
They were the wind beneath your
wings. On the wings of love.
As sponsored by Red Bull.
Every time a square comes, gets their wings. Will do.
Hey there, I am going with, this is not PTR, okay. I'm going to go with Stetson.
Hey, that's always a good choice. I'm ready.
Bottom.
Well, you know, I've definitely had to convince a few people on how to open up their jaw. And, you know, I'm like a shark because I just keep on moving no matter what.
I'm glad I learned very quickly.
Indeed, indeed, indeed. Ms. Definitely indeed. That being said, though, I think the boat's name, gosh,
It almost escapes me. I think I'm gonna say, let's go with my gut tonight, and I'm gonna say the orca.
Well, you know what? The guts are working tonight, so I'm going with the gut and Stetson. I agree.
All right, all right. There we go.
Okay, Tom Cruise, use your witchcraft on me. I'm ready. I'm so excited, and it's not just because I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew, but because I freaking love Disney. So my answer is going to be, hi-ho, hi-ho, it's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Wow. I absolutely agree. I don't think I could not agree with that.
Thank you, Tom Cruise!
Thank you. Well, as some of you know, I am a real estate agent. I am the CEO, CFO, secretary, and bitch boy for the Right Lane Realty Group. I'm a pretty much a one-man show. I do have my associate in the audience. I thought she was here, Charmy. But anyways, if you have any referrals around the nation, I'm networked with all 50 states, so I can take your referrals. But I do practice in California. So if you're looking to buy, sell, or invest, call Jessica Lane, because you're always in the right lane with Jessica Lane.
That's all tonight for Clubhouse Squares.
Thank you.
Thank all of our Clubhouse celebrities.
That was fun.
Our Clubhouse contestants, our Clubhouse host, Bobby K, and you, our Clubhouse fans. Come back next week for another episode of Clubhouse Squares. Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. Yikes. The anticipation's building. Bye.
Bye.